Hello and welcome to another in my series of updates from your state capitol. On Tuesday, February 17th, we gaveled in for Legislative Day 16. I was proud to vote for my colleague from Columbus, Senator Ed Harbison, who brought to us Senate Bill 18 that made it easier to receive college credit for military service. That bill passed unanimously and moves on to the House for consideration over there. Senate Bill 62, which was brought to us by Senator Tyler Harper, involved expanding probate court jurisdiction to deal with fish and game violations. I was actually the only no vote on this bill, the reason being that legislation with the courts typically comes through the Judiciary Committee, which I chair. I'm a strong supporter of the committee process. I believe that those with the expertise in the subject matter need to fully vet the legislation, and that was the reason for my no vote. Senate Bill 62 now moves over to the House for consideration there. We also welcomed Congressman Sanford Bishop to the state Senate. He gave some remarks, and while he and I don't always agree, I did thank him for his vote in support of the Keystone XL pipeline in the House of Representatives earlier this year. On Wednesday, February the 18th, we gaveled in for Legislative Day 17. My colleague Senator Hunter Hill brought forward Senate Bill 58, the Georgia Leadership and Service Admissions Act. This will allow every member of the Georgia General Assembly, along with our constitutional officers, to appoint one student to an ROTC program at our university system institutions. I think it's a wonderful idea. It's a great way to invite people into military service. I supported the bill when Senator Hill brought it last year, was proud to do so again this year. It passed, and it moves on to the House for consideration there. Senate Bill 79, which came from my colleague Senator Renee Unterman, the Victims Compensation Fund expansion, adjusted the amounts of funding for victims and their families who are having to bury a victim of a violent crime or deal with other situations involving counseling. I voted for it. I believe strongly in providing resources to our victims. This fund, it is important to note, is fully funded through fines that are paid for by criminal defendants, so there's no additional tax involved. That passed, and it moves on to the House for consideration over there. We also had a special recognition during the day at the State Senate for all of our Vietnam War veterans on the 40th anniversary of the Vietnam War. And I was proud to be a part of that, to salute our veterans, to thank them for their service some 40 years ago. We concluded our day and came back on Thursday, February 19th, for Legislative Day 18. Senator Dean Burke brought forward that day Senate Bill 51 on biological product substitutes. It's a fairly complex issue involving the development of additional pharmaceuticals. I had read the bill a couple of times, but frankly, still was not comfortable with the language, so I voted against it. It moves on to the House for consideration over there. We also recognized our friends from Georgia Farm Bureau affiliates from all over our state and recognized the tremendous contribution they make to Georgia agriculture. Finally, we rounded out the week on Friday, February 20th for Legislative Day 19. We passed Senate Bill 4, which primarily applies to Atlanta's Beltline development, and it allows redevelopment along that line with public-private partnerships. I voted for the bill, and it moves on to the House for consideration over there. Finally, Senator Jeff Mullis brought us Senate Bill 72, Tanya's Law, which strengthens penalties for the injury or killing of law enforcement animals. That bill passed. It moves on to the House for consideration there. We adjourned on Friday. We will return on Monday, February 23rd, for Legislative Day 20. As always, I hope you won't hesitate to contact my office with any questions or concerns. You can reach me at 404-463-3931. You can reach us online at joshmckoon.com or, of course, any of the social media channels, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, at Josh McKoon. I look forward to returning to talk with you next legislative week. Thank you.